So we performed this relatively complex analysis linking this high resolution mortality data for the whole England and Wales, disaggregated in more than 34,000 areas across the two countries. And we linked this data with the temperature, looking in particular at the potential effect of the last heat wave of July 2022. We were able for each day to compute what could be the potential impact in terms of excess number of deaths in each area. And therefore, we're able to follow the progress, let's say, of the heat wave in terms of forecasted data and to measure for each area how many more deaths you could have given the heat wave. What we found was that there were an increase in more or less 950 deaths in the 3 days of the official days of the heat waves. And these number of deaths, just to give you an idea, are more than the one forecasted in terms of heat-related mortality for a full, let's say, normal year. So the event was massive. In addition to the short-term forecast, we have also long-term predictions of temperature at a quite localized level. And therefore, we are able to use more or less the same analytical setting to predict what will be the impacts in the future, actually under different scenarios of climate change. And we will be able to tell how many more deaths, for example, there will be in each area, depending on these different scenarios. And I think this is important also from a scientific point of view, of course, but also from a communication perspective, in order to let the public and politicians know about different actions that can be taken to prevent at least some of these impacts. We know that this kind of event will become more common. And of course, the frequency will depend on the different path that we will, in a way, choose for the future, depending on the kind of emissions we will generate nowadays and in the near future.